Massachusetts receives the highest marks in a new report that puts states' healthcare systems on a scorecard. That report was put together by the Commonwealth Fund using federal health data from 2021. States were reviewed on 58 measures on health outcomes, equity, affordability, and Massachusetts fared the best, followed by Hawaii and New Hampshire. Maternal deaths here in U.S. hospitals are declining. A new study from the government's Office on Women's Health studied more than 11 million hospital patients over 14 years. Research showed that delivery-related deaths in hospitals dropped by 57%. The maternal mortality rate increased when deliveries not done in hospitals were factored in. More than 80% of pregnancy-related deaths were found to be preventable.
And 5 on your health tonight. The CDC is set to decide whether adults age 60 and older can receive that RSV vaccine for the first time ever this fall. Here to talk about that is Dr. Kristen Moffitt, an infectious disease specialist at Boston Children's Hospital. Always great to see you.
Hey, Dr. Moffitt, it's great to see you. Well, as you know, RSV infections also cause serious symptoms in young kids. So you've been following those developments with the adult vaccine very, very closely. So do you have any significant concerns about the shot's safety or effectiveness?
I don't have any major concerns. What we know from the available data from both Pfizer and GSK that have now been reviewed both by the FDA Advisory Committee and the CDC Advisory Committee is that both shots seem to be very effective at reducing lower respiratory tract infection due to RSV in individuals over the age of 60. This was especially effective in the first RSV season after getting the RSV vaccine, but persisted even through the second RSV season. So based on those data, the CDC's advisory committee is making a recommendation that individuals over the age of 60 should consider getting the RSV vaccine after a discussion with their doctor. And it seems like an appropriate recommendation.
Doctor, we know that the CDC's panel of experts is still looking at data about that RSV shot for pregnant women that would protect newborns. What can you tell us about that?
Right. So Pfizer submitted data to the FDA, and those data have been reviewed by the FDA's advisory committee back in May. This was the same RSV vaccine given to pregnant women in their second or third trimester of pregnancy, and it showed that that vaccine regimen offered significant protection against severe lower respiratory tract infection in babies born to women who'd received the RSV vaccine. This was especially true for infants under the age of 3 months. It was about 80% effective at preventing lower disease in those infants. So that is going forward with further review with the CDC's advisory committee today, and we might expect a vote about maternal immunization to protect infants against RSV from the advisory committee to the CDC sometime soon.
Dr. Moffitt, let's look ahead a little bit. Health officials have said that they hope to offer a new COVID-19 booster. Okay, you got the COVID-19 booster with a flu shot this fall.
Yeah.
Do you think it would be too much to add an RSV vaccine in there too? And let me piggyback that with, can our immune system safely handle so many shots?
Yeah, I think our immune system can handle so many shots. I think if we think about the pediatric routine vaccine schedule, infants and children get immunized against far more than 3 pathogens at a time very routinely. And we continue to do that as adults when we get a tetanus booster. It's often combined with other things. So I think these things need to be studied. We need to be sure that if an RSV vaccine is given at the same time as a COVID vaccine and potentially an influenza vaccine, that the immune response to any of those individual vaccines is not diminished. And we need to, of course, make sure it's safe and have data that suggests that. But I don't think based on just getting 3 vaccines alone at the same time, there would be concern that it would be too much.
Dr. Moffitt, thank you so much. As always, stay well.
Great to see you, Dr. Moffitt.